Preparation and planning are key to working in the lab. Being prepared means understanding the hazards of any chemicals you'll be working with. The place to find that information is the Safety Data Sheet, or SDS. The SDS provides detailed information about the properties of a chemical, its hazards, and how to protect yourself from those hazards. In this video, we'll look at a sample SDS for isopropyl alcohol, a common household chemical. Isopropyl alcohol can be found in home first aid kits and is used to treat minor scrapes, cuts, and wounds. So without further ado, let's take a look at a sample SDS. All safety data sheets have the same 16-section format. The first section identifies the chemical and also gives the name and address of the manufacturer. Chemicals are known by different common and formal names, so if you're unsure about which chemical you're using, check to make sure the name of the chemical on the SDS matches that on the container. Section 2 identifies hazards. Hazards can be identified in three different ways. The first is called a signal word. This serves as a kind of first alert. Danger, this chemical is hazardous. Pay attention. Chemicals that are less hazardous may use the word warning instead of danger, while non-hazardous chemicals won't have a signal word at all. The second way a hazard is identified is through a pictogram. There are 9 pictograms used to describe all of the possible hazards of chemicals. Isopropyl alcohol has 2. The first one, a flame, is easily understood. Isopropyl alcohol will burn. The second, an exclamation point, alerts you to other potential hazards of this chemical. The third and most detailed way of identifying hazards is by actually naming specific hazards or hazard classes. These are described by hazard statements. Isopropyl alcohol has 4 principal hazards. 1, it is a highly flammable liquid and vapor. Keep away from heat, sparks, open flames, and hot surfaces. No smoking. 2 and 3, isopropyl alcohol may cause both mild skin irritation and serious eye irritation. The last hazard class identified for isopropyl alcohol is that it could have narcotic effects. It may cause drowsiness or dizziness. Avoid breathing mist, vapors, or spray. A quick side note, drinking isopropyl alcohol could result in poisoning or even death, so don't confuse it with ethanol found in beer, wine, and liquor. Section 3 provides the formula or molecular weight for the chemical, or for each component if it contains more than one chemical. Section 4 describes simple first aid measures to follow if you are exposed. Exposure can occur by inhaling some of the chemical or getting it in your eyes or on your skin. First aid measures are written in the form of standard precautionary statements, which reinforce familiar laboratory safety rules. Immediately wash any affected areas with plenty of water. Use the eye wash or safety shower if needed. Sections 5 and 6 contain reference information for firefighters and other emergency personnel who respond to a fire or chemical spills. Section 7 describes ways to minimize risk when handling and storing a chemical. Many of these recommendations are in the form of standard precautionary statements, such as P233, keep container tightly closed. Section 8 is about personal protection, specifically the use of personal protective equipment, or PPE. The information here reinforces important safety rules. Wear protective gloves, protective clothing, and eye protection to avoid eye and skin contact with chemicals. Section 9 summarizes physical and chemical properties. This can be a handy reference section for lab reports or presentations. Section 10 tells you about the stability and reactivity of the chemical. Mixing chemicals can be dangerous if you don't know what you're doing. Section 11 provides reference information concerning the toxicology of a chemical, how it can hurt you. You'll see a lot of abbreviations here, such as LD50 and LC50. The exact details are beyond the scope of a high school chemistry class, but the main thing to know is that the toxicity of a chemical is divided into acute or short-term effects versus chronic or long-term effects. For isopropyl alcohol, the hazards are mainly due to short-term exposure. This reinforces what we learned in Section 2, that isopropyl alcohol can irritate skin and eyes, and may make you drowsy if you breathe it. Section 12 provides information about the effect a chemical may have in the environment. Unfortunately, we don't have much info here. Sections 13 through 16 concern regulations for the disposal, transportation, and industrial use of chemicals and are beyond the scope of this video. Remember, working safely with chemicals requires that you recognize their hazards, understand risks, minimize those risks, and prepare for emergencies. All of this information can be found in the SDS, which is why it's such an important document and crucial for your safety in the lab.